A KARE 11 office floor.
Interesting.
Is a strange place to begin piecing together a puzzle.
It's like a collage.
As the picture comes together, Daniel Schultz's health records paint a story hidden from public view until now.
When you look at the records you got, in your opinion, is there false billing there?
Almost definitely. Absolutely.
Daniel's records led KARE 11 to watch on a Saturday morning as a pickup truck pulls into the back of a Whole Foods store. It's driven by a man named Meyer Belkin, who owns a network of sober homes. Belkin and another man load the vehicle, just like Daniel says he used to do, with donated groceries destined for the residents of Belkin's sober homes. Free food for people who likely need it. Yet, for taxpayers, our investigation discovered these weekly Whole Foods runs come with a hefty hidden bill.
He was billing my insurance for that time that I was with him, helping him and his company.
Daniel's insurance is Medicaid. He's in addiction recovery and last January moved here into one of Belkin's Minneapolis sober homes. On day one, Daniel says he was told he needed an assessment.
Like, I truly thought this assessment was to, you know, give me permission to live in one of these houses.
Daniel didn't know. The assessment was done by a software company called Kairos, which along with its nonprofit arm, Refocus Recovery, provide and charge Medicaid $1 a minute for peer services, basically mentors for people battling addiction. A business model, Kairos told investors, would make them $30 million in gross profit by the end of this year. Belkin's sober home company, Act 2, is a partner of Kairos, and Belkin himself works as a peer provider for Kairos. So getting that Kairos assessment
allowed them to start charging my insurance for things that I was unaware of.
You were receiving peer services without even knowing you were signed up for peer services?
Correct.
Daniel got suspicious months later.
Yeah.
When he tried to sign up for peer services to get help with rides to and from his outpatient treatment and AA meetings, only to learn he was already in the Cairo system being billed for by Belkin and others.
But there were no services that had happened. And so that's when a red flag went off.
He later demanded his records from Kairos. Kairos Chief Compliance Officer Kathleen Finnegan, a former Ramsey prosecutor and top attorney at the State Commerce Department, eventually handed him, after a month of waiting, a printed out spreadsheet he had to stretch across the floor and tape together just to begin to read.
Is this how a client should be provided their medical record?
At a bare minimum, that, in my view, violates, at the very least, the spirit of the law.
Brandon Thompson is one of the Twin Cities' leading medical malpractice attorneys. He points out Minnesota's patient rights law mandates the release of complete and current information in terms and language the patient can reasonably be expected to understand. Kairos told KARE 11 in a statement, they provide clients with a complete copy of their medical records in a timely manner in compliance with state and federal law.
A lot of information that is literally cut off the page, and so half the sentence is gone.
In addition to cut off sentences,
we don't have those notes on these ones, do we?
Daniel's records often offer no explanation of what service he allegedly received.
They were almost incomprehensible. The goal here should be to make it so it's easy for people to read, not so that they have to print stuff out and put together some jigsaw puzzle and tape it together on the floor.
Kairos wrote to KARE 11, if any client information was cut off due to formatting when printed, it was certainly not intentional. It's going on 3 months, and Kairos has not responded to Daniel's emails asking for the missing information.
They're a software company. This is in a computer.
A company, KARE 11's analysis of state data revealed, had, by last October, billed taxpayers for peer services more than $14 million. After putting the puzzle together as much as possible, Daniel has two conclusions about the $2,072 billed in his name while living in Belkin's sober home.
So some of the events were just like made up.
And other billed events like the grocery runs appear improper. Example, on February 18th, Daniel's records show Belkin billed Medicaid $120. Daniel has texts that show when Meyer asked him, he agreed to help Meyer that day with a Whole Foods run, to which Meyer responded.
He says, "Darling, that would be amazing."
They discuss via text how three other sober home residents are joining, and Meyer writes,
"I guess four people works."
State law requires peer services be provided one-to-one, no groups.
I was told that that was fine.
In prior reporting, Care 11 documented Cairo's peer, Ruby McNiff, explaining how she was instructed by a Cairo supervisor to bill for groups of people by falsely documenting she actually had a series of back-to-back one-on-one meetings.
You'd meet with a group of people from, say, 4 to 6, but then bill it as if they were 12 to 2, 2 to 4, 4 to 6.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
Belkin declined to be interviewed, but about whether he improperly billed on these weekly grocery runs, he wrote in an email to Care 11 that recent revelations regarding back-to-back billing have been made, and we immediately stopped that practice. Prior to that, we had been led to believe that it was within the ethical billing practices. He also wrote, our charting was supervised by Kairos.
It doesn't seem to me like there's any oversight, regulation. Who has eyes on this stuff?
The answer to that question is supposed to be the Minnesota Department of Human Services, DHS. Our investigation continues as we discover DHS was warned that the Kairos Refocus Partnership was billing for groups and services not provided, but failed to fully investigate.
Downtown St. Paul in November. Inside the River Center, Minnesota's largest conference of addiction treatment providers is underway. The Diamond Sponsors, an unlikely pairing, a private company called Kairos and the Minnesota Department of Human Services, the state agency, which had just wrapped up an investigation into allegations Kairos was billing Medicaid illegally.
It's critical that when fraud is alleged, especially on a substantial nature like this, that a deep dive get done.
Care 11 shared records with Republican State Senator Jim Abler that reveal DHS's investigation of Kairos Medicaid billing was more toe-dip than deep dive.
It seems like they're asleep at the wheel.
The for-profit Kairos and their nonprofit arm, Refocus Recovery, provide what are known as peer services. Think mentors who themselves have been through recovery for people battling addiction. Internal records obtained by Care 11 reveal Kairos told investors that by billing Medicaid, they project by the end of this year to make nearly $30 million in gross profit. CARE's analysis of state data found by last October, the Kairos Refocus pairing already billed more than $14 million. While Kairos told us in a statement they monitor billing practices closely to ensure they meet statutory requirements,
I don't remember any of these actually happening.
Poring over billing records with clients, Care 11, in prior reports, documented allegations Kairos and Refocus billed Medicaid for peer services never provided.
So some of the events were just like made up.
You're saying that didn't happen?
I'm saying that outright did not happen.
State law requires peer services be provided to clients one-on-one. Yet, Care 11 discovered internal emails showing Kairos holding taxpayer-funded movie nights, instructing workers, in all caps, this is a billable event. Bring two clients to the movie, and it counts as a two-hour appointment for each client.
Okay.
And former Kairos employees like Ruby McNiff shared records showing they were instructed to bill for groups of people.
That's what I was told I could do, so I did.
None of these allegations should have come as a surprise to the state. They'd already been warned.
Records obtained by Care 11 through state data practice requests show in both November of 2022 and February of 2023, DHS's Office of Inspector General received complaints that Kairos's nonprofit partner Refocus Recovery was improperly billing in groups and for peer recovery services that are not occurring. In response, DHS corresponded with Kairos VP Jason Lennox, looked at just six clients' records for a 3-month window, and found a few relatively minor paperwork errors, like missing signatures.
When we asked, DHS confirmed no attempt was made to actually call a client or peer provider to determine if the services that taxpayers were billed for were actually provided.
Refocus got an $850 slap on the wrist. Case closed. DHS never even addressed the actual allegations of group and false billing.
Are you surprised that we found evidence of those very things?
No, I'm not surprised, because you followed the trail that a good investigator should be following, right? And we follow the money.
DFL State Senator John Hoffman chairs the Human Services Committee, which has oversight of DHS. We shared with him the records we uncovered.
What were your thoughts when you read through that DHS OIG investigation?
My first response was, that's it?
It's not even the first red flag DHS received about Kairos and Refocus. In July 2022, the Alliance for Recovery-Centered Organizations, or ARCO, revoked Refocus Recovery's membership. In this letter, ARCO cited concerns about business practices, undue influence on Refocus Recovery by Kairos, a for-profit entity. It stated, there is a partnership in existence between Refocus Recovery and Kairos from which both entities stand to attain substantial financial gains.
Minnesota usually requires ARCO membership, so this move threatened Refocus's and therefore Kairos's ability to bill Medicaid.
Records show they appealed directly to DHS Commissioner Jody Harpstead and even threatened to sue the state. Commissioner Harpstead then sent this letter to Refocus and Kairos's lawyer, former United States Attorney Erica McDonald, granting certification to keep on billing Medicaid. DHS has since paid their diamond-level conference co-sponsor millions of tax dollars.
Based on what you're looking at there, does DHS need to reopen their investigation?
They need to have an investigation. It's time for DHS to act. And to not act is to fail in their mission.
Daniel Larson, the founder of Kairos and Refocus Recovery, has declined multiple interview requests. So is Tim Sanders, the former state lawmaker and current mayor of Blaine, who until stepping down a week ago was executive director of Refocus Recovery. DHS also would not do an interview, sending a statement that reads in part, DHS takes oversight of taxpayer dollars very seriously and has strict processes in place to investigate when allegations of improper billing arise. We continue working to improve peer support systems and program integrity oversight of these systems in order to ensure Minnesotans are receiving the best possible care. With Recovery, Inc., I'm AJ Legault.